You may know that Azure Data Factory supports integration with Git repos and VSTS. But did you know that Data Factory now integrates with GitHub repos too? Gaurav Malhotra is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hello, this is Lara Rubbelke with Azure Friday, and today with me I've got Gaurav Malhotra, who is a Senior Program Manager with Azure Data Factory, and he's going to show some great new updates that we have to integrate Azure Data Factory with GitHub. So what would you like to show us today?
So last time when I was here, we said that the entire UX that we have with Data Factory, the visual tools that we have, which allow you to build your data integration workflows in a code-free manner, can be backed with a VSTS Git account.
Yes.
So essentially, you can do source control, collaboration, and versioning using that Git integration. So today, what we are saying is that not only you can use VSTS Git as a code repository, but you can also use GitHub. So you can just select this, and as you can see that what I did was we have this drop down. So right now I'm in the live Data Factory mode where you do changes, and when you say publish, it goes directly to the Data Factory service. There's no repo backing it. Mm-hmm. So if you want to look at audit trail as to who changed what, you cannot do that.
Right.
So if I say set up code repository from here, it opens up this drawer on the right, and here you can now select GitHub. And once you select GitHub, you can provide your GitHub account. So I'm just going to type my GitHub account here. And as you type the GitHub account, we start pulling your repositories in the GitHub account automatically. So you can see that I have one repo in my GitHub account. And once I select my repo, I can now provide what is the collaboration branch that I want to use, so that different developers who are developing in their feature branch will use this collaboration branch as the source of truth. So in this case, I'm going to select master as my collaboration branch as well and keep the root folder as is. And with this checkbox, what we are saying is that, as you can see in my current factory, I have a bunch of pipelines and data sets, link services, connections that I've created. And I want to import all of that in GitHub at this moment as well. So I can keep this checkbox as is. And here with this radio button, we are saying that we want to import all of the code representation of this data factory into the collaboration branch, which I just selected over here as master. So once I click save, at this point in time, we are creating that connection to the GitHub account. We are taking everything that is there in your data factory and putting the code representation into your repo. So this is my GitHub. And if I go in this particular repo now, you'll see that all these folders have been created. And inside each of these folders, there is this code representation of your data factory assets. And you saw that we had folders for data sets, integration runtime, link services, pipelines, and triggers. So now if I do any change, it would be reflected in this particular GitHub account.
Fantastic, fantastic. So can we see how this works as you make some changes?
Yes. So let's do a very simple one where I have this pipeline where I'm getting data from a bunch of sources. I'm prepping data in notebook, doing some transformation again in Databricks notebooks and loading my data warehouse. So here I'm just going to add some description to my pipeline saying that pipeline to improve online traffic sales using machine learning. Let's just say that, right? So once I say this, you can now publish. You can just say that I want to save this all, save this to my master branch.
Okay.
And at this point, if I go to my data factory and look at this pipeline JSON, so if I go to pipelines and look at the improve online traffic pipeline JSON, as you can see, there was a 12-second update, and you can see the description is right here.
Right.
So as I'm saving, those updates are going to your GitHub account right then. The other thing that you can do is that right now I was in the master branch, but you could create new branches. So the typical way developers work is that they create feature branches to do their development, and then they merge those changes back to the master branch as pull requests. So let's say I'm going to create a feature branch and I'm going to use my alias to create that feature branch. So at this point, that branch is automatically created in your GitHub. So if you go to GitHub and you look at the branches, if I go back here and look at my Git repo, and if I look at the branches, I can see that there's another branch, Gamal, that just got created. And now I'm in my feature branch. So now what I can do is that I can essentially go to any other pipeline. Let's go to this particular pipeline. And I just had some description that I typed in earlier that I'm just going to copy over here. So I'm just going to say it's a Databricks pipeline to clean data and classify records. So now let's just save this, right? And now this particular change is going in my feature branch, which is Gamal. And now if, let's say I want to take these changes and deploy to the Data Factory. So what we do in Data Factory is that we are not trying to build Git inside Data Factory. So you are only allowed to publish from the master branch, which is the source of truth. And for you to take these changes to the master branch, you need to create a pull request. So if you click this link, we actually take you to GitHub. So this, not the one. If I say okay over here, and if I say create pull request, so it takes you right to that location, and you can see that it specifies that this is the description that we have changed. I could say create pull request, and I created a pull request at this point, and I'm trying to merge it back automatically to master. It didn't detect any conflicts. And at this point, you could open code reviews and have other developers code review your code as well. And I'm going to say merge the pull request. So at this point, this change is now in the master. So if I go here and change the branch to the master branch and look at this particular pipeline, I would see the description updated over there as well.
Great. Yeah.
So you can see now the description is in, for this particular pipeline is there in the master branch as well. And now I can publish these changes to my Data Factory.
That's great. So you can really set up some good collaboration across developers working with Azure Data Factory, you know, creating their own branches, merging, doing pulls and merges into the master.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Yes. And right now we are on public GitHub, the one that I'm showcasing. We are also working to release enterprise GitHub integration. So it's, if you as a customer has an, have an enterprise GitHub and you want to use it with Data Factory, you will be able to use that as well.
Okay.
And also for authentication, you can use the OAuth authentication to verify your GitHub credentials and use the GitHub account of your choice.
Great. Now, where would we go to learn more? How can we start playing with this on our own?
So you will see that we have documentation on our Azure Data Factory documentation where you can go and look at all of these things that I just talked about in terms of GitHub integration with Data Factory and get started with it.
Thank you so much. This is great to see. And I think the solid integration that we have with GitHub is going to be a great help for the developers that are building out our cloud data applications.
Yes.
So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Today on Azure Friday, we've been learning all about Azure Data Factory and the GitHub integration.